Well, bora da, good morning. And as you can see, I'm at the mental. And I can hear a bit of some machinery or some sort of power tool, something like that. Well, it was. But yeah, I've just done a walk up to the mental vlog. So you may be interested in that, or you may have watched that actually, but that's a separate video. But yeah, anyway, I'm back at the mental. First glance, I don't know, they've been doing something, but that's been going on for some time. It's where Bryn Golau was, which is the secure ward where the patients were put if they were a danger to themselves, to other patients, or to the staff. They were putting Bryn Golau. But yeah, first glance, not a lot happening, apart from, I can hear it now. Sounds like a power tool going somewhere right in the, don't know if you can hear that. It's like a grinder or a power tool or something. Or is it coming from there? It's a job to tell where it's coming from. Anyway, yeah, first glance, not a lot going on. So I'll pop down to front gate and then Jones Brothers entrance, see if my mate's there. I can't call him Camo Man now, because he looks like a proper security guard now. He's got the hi-vis on, or he has done for the last few weeks. So, yeah, they're set for a 10 million cash injection. Their final business plan is going to be put together. Jones Brothers. So hopefully they'll get some money and they can start doing whatever they're going to do. I can hear some sort of power tool. This job to, don't know where it's coming from, but yeah, look at that. Keep out. Yeah, we all know that. Don't come anywhere near here with the drone. Otherwise it'll be blasted out of the sky. So yeah, anyway, obviously, basically, yeah, so the final business plan, the first plan they put in has been approved. So they're set to get 7 million. And then the government's top-up fund, they top it up with 3 million, so they're in line to get 10 million quid. So that'll come in handy, won't it? And hopefully something will start. But DCC, Denbigh County Council, have said that when I contacted them middle of last year, they said that early this year things are going to start. But they know they're cash strapped. All the councils are cash strapped at the moment. They're doing stuff on the railroad, but they've had money from the Welsh Government, the active travel fund, something like that it's called. But they've been given money to do that. But yeah, they've put the cables in here. I've documented that, updated all along here, down that way, and all the way up to behind towards where Bryn Golau was. And one of the workmen was here, and I said to him, you know, what's he doing, putting cables in? Yeah, it's electric, he said. I said, for the mental? He said, yeah. So, but that was a few months back now. But yeah, the Denbighshire County Council, well, majority of the councils, they're all strapped for money at the moment. But nothing going on. So I'll head down to the front gate. I'm a shufty down there, and I'll head to Jones Brothers and my usual wander down the haunted cinder track. I remember to mention it was haunted then, but so yeah, anyway, head down to the what was the front gate. So the Lego bricks, giant Lego bricks. So this was the front gates, front entrance. And here comes the car. Mental camera, press record. You get a car. And I've said it once, I'll say it again. The front door there is where I witnessed a patient fell to his death. I'd be about 8, something like that. I used to do the taxis, you know, from Loveland Garage. I pulled up there, my mother it was went in and I was in the car. Right at the front gate there, front entrance I should say. And this patient came out, he was in a dressing gown and bald head. And he looked around like, he looked at me and he attempted to come down the steps and he fell, bang, he didn't put his hands out or nothing. And he was just still. And I was like, ah, because like I say, it was only 7 or 8, something like that. It was only a little kid. And then people came round and stuff, you know. And then we found out later, the next day, that he was dead as soon as he hit that the steps. He died instantly and I was the only one that witnessed it. And I'll never forget it. I always remember it to this day. That's where the trees come down there. And we've fenced it off now. Caution, keep out. But yeah, it was right across the road. It just went through the hedge there. It blocked the road. So they had to come in and chop it up so they could clear the road. So yeah, I always remember that. Patient fell and fall to his death and I was the only one that witnessed it. Something you don't forget, isn't it? But anyway, keep going. Just there, on the left there was the old the mental farm. And just a bit further on is Jones Villa's entrance, and I'll have a wander down the haunted cinder track. This was part of the mental farm. This is supply all the meat, the chickens, eggs, used to have. Still a load of white pickups there. You can just about make out there, Pennant Farm. And buildings, that's what it was called, but originally when it was the mental farm, it wasn't called Penance, but off the top of my head I can't remember what it was called, but I have covered it before. But yeah, they used to grow all the fruit and veg in the grounds and stuff. And this was the farm. Like I say, I have done a separate video on a few videos and what they paid for the buildings and stuff. Used to have their own water supplies and things like that. So yeah, if you're interested, like I say, over 25 plus years I've been documenting this place. I ain't gonna stop anytime soon. So I don't think, like I say, I can't call him Camo Man now. I'm not gonna trespass. I'm not gonna cross that dotted line. No way I'm gonna trespass. So if Mr. Security makes an appearance, I can film him. Even though he is on private property and he can be easily seen. Look at all these white pickups. Normally green. Jones Brothers all green, but there's a load of... I'll zoom in a bit. See the white pickups there? There's all their offices and stuff. But I'm not crossing the line. Yeah, so if he makes an appearance, even though he's on private land... but he can be easily seen from the public. I can film him, and there's nothing he can do. But if he went into one of the port cabins, and I zoomed in, then he can expect privacy. If I zoom in through the window, say, you know, I would be breaking the law, shall we say, because he would expect privacy. But if, even though, he was out, he can be easily seen from the public, then you can film him, there's nothing he can do. If I step over that line onto there and he came to the gate and he said to me, stop filming, I'd have to stop filming. But if I step over that line onto the road, I can just switch my camera back on and start filming him. Those are the laws, the UK law, filming laws, which you need to know if you're a filmmaker. You need to look up the rules and regulations. Anyway, private road, but it is a footpath, so heads to King's Mill. So this is the cinder track, which is haunted. Did I mention it was haunted? Might not have mentioned that. Anyway, this is the haunted cinder track, which is haunted. This is looking to female 7A, 7B and 8 woods. The roof is going on them, and the back, because you can see daylight through the windows, which you shouldn't be able to see daylight, but the floors on them, the upper floors on that ward, or them wards, is solid. There's a lot of the upper floors in other buildings. Very dangerous. It's like tissue paper, I would describe it. You just walk on it and phew, just drop through it. But there, it's quite solid actually. And then more wards. But if you're new to this channel and you got a bit of an interest in the mental and what have you, 25 plus years been documenting the place. Stories, history, news, anything that's going on, anecdotes and stuff like that. Walkabouts, tours, or anything, you know, that's going on. Regular updates and stuff like that. They're all on my channel. As I said, in case I'd never mentioned it, been documenting this place for 25 plus years now. I stopped counting at 25 years, quarter of a century. And I ain't gonna stop anytime soon. So I'll just drop down here and just show you the pavilion. Was the rugby and cricket pavilion. It's where we just come down on our bikes. That gate, railings I should say, not gate. Well, there is a gate a bit further up, but that wasn't there. It was all clear. We used to come through the mental, always through the grounds. We never used to come on the top road and down and around the mental. We always used to go through the mental. We used to come down here on our bikes, down left and onto the pavilion, which was then in one piece. Bottom half was brick, the top half was all timber. But many years ago now, it got burnt down. There was a fella used to live there. He was a bit of a tramp, like a vagrant and whatever, you homeless. And he used to live there. How the hell he survived was the winter and that. But many years now, it burnt down. And one of the firemen, he was watching my videos and stuff. This was going back a few years now. And he said, "Oh, dig that video out." He was one of the firemen. They were getting water from the river. And he said he took a photo of it. It was in full blaze. Or film, I think he took of it. Film, actually, video with his phone. But he never got back to me. So that would have been quite interesting. But if you want to see what it looked like when it was intact, check out my videos. Just type in rugby or cricket pavilion or North Hills Hospital pavilion or whatever, and you'll see what it was like before the fire. And there it is. Well, there it was. That's the bottom half of it. Bottom half was the brick, and the top half was the timber. This side, that's the rugby, and that side is the cricket. So but like I say, we're going back quite a few years now. Went on fire. Just the top half burns, obviously, because of the timber. And as I say, if you want to see what it looked like when it was intact, check out my the videos. And it was with patient labour. The cricket ground and the rugby pitch and all that. It was all built mostly by patient labour. All the patients that could work, they all had jobs and stuff. They used to work in the gardens, in the, you know, the whatever job they were allocated, that's what they would do. There was even a team of patients that used to chip the coal to the correct size so it would fit into the boilers. And like I say, any patient that could work used to have jobs, and the hospital, it wouldn't have survived as long as it did without the patients, without patient labour. So that's where the rugby and cricket pavilion was. So anyway, so that'll do me. Finish the video now on the top road. Best view of the front buildings in the middle. As always, thanks for watching. No sign of Mr. Security today. Anyway, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you again.